cocaine and dreaming. Oh, I was trying to do a cute little intro, but I stubbed my toe. Hello, friend people. It has been like, bitch, a month. It's been a month. I haven't seen y'all in a month. Ugh. I started school. Y'all know I was out of school for like a year and a half. Now I started nursing school. I did all my prereqs, and now I'm like one step closer to being where I want to be, to leveling up in the world. And with that comes a lot of more responsibility than I have ever had or know really how to deal with, which is why you haven't seen me in a month. I'm sorry. I've missed you guys a lot. I don't even think you realize it. I think I've missed you guys more than you missed me. I really did miss you, but I'm back now, I guess, for now, until the next time I take a break. But anyways, this week I don't have any exams, which is why I'm able to film this long-ass video. I just peeped. The album has over 15 songs. Well over an hour. So let's get right into it, because again, this is going to be a long-ass video. This is Lil Nas X Montero. I've been waiting for this album. You guys let me know what album you think so far has been the best. Is this album going to be as hyped up as I've been making it in my freaking head? I hope so. I really do hope so. I'm kind of nervous. Let's get into it. Subscribe. Like. We passed 100,000 subscribers. Check out the new setup, by the way. So much has freaking changed. I haven't, though. I'm still a little old Favour. But yeah, look at my setup. It's different. I still have my vinyls. I got some, like, ethereal vibes going on here. Ruth Bader Ginsburg, because she's a huge inspiration. A woman that I can only dream to be. And my plackety plaque that I've worked 3 years towards. And you guys helped me get. So, yeah. I started nursing school. The new setup has changed. But the channel and content is still vibing and popping. So, enough talking. Let's get into Montero Lil Nas X. We've already reacted to Montero. We've already seen the huge controversy. I gave my opinions on that. Go watch that content. But next up we have... Let's see. Dead Right Now. He's always weird. I imagine this is maybe gonna sound like the song with Cardi B. Like, it gives me, like, grungy vibes. Like, we're going to the crypts of hell. Let's get it. Okay, for the first of all, the first, can I talk? First thing I'm noticing so far is like, I don't know what's going on, but I feel like it's like I'm ascending to heaven, but also going to hell at the same time. I don't really know what's going on, but I'm here for it, so.
Break, break, 911, somebody come get this bitch.
Drink and react is what I've just learned. Somebody come get this bee, huh? Oh my god.
Break, break. 911, somebody come get this bitch.
Hey!
Eat my shit.
Featuring DaBaby. It doesn't. Sounds like DaBaby, but I don't, it has no feet. Megan Thee Stallion! Hold on. Well, we already know friggin' Jack Harlow. We handprint on her ass cheek, we know. But Doja Cat, Elton freaking John? From the Beatles? Rainbows collide. Megan Thee Stallion, who else? Miley? I hate it. Lil Nas X? You've outdone yourself. Let's go. Yeah. You know I never did you wrong. Niggas are singing.
Even though I'm right here by the phone, dog. You know you never used to call. Keep it that way now.
Oh.
Treat you like you're dead right now.
Wait. He said you never used to call, bitch. Keep that same energy. You weren't checking for me when I was broke. Don't check for me now that I'm up. Period. And let's talk about how Montero, Call Me By Your Name, the song that had so much controversy, bitch, has over 1 billion streams. Y'all, ugh, crying in the closet, but jacking off to it in pu- Calm down, Favour. What are you saying sometimes?
I'm on your head right now.
Right now. Cause he's up now. Now you can't.
And my sister house to hold some songs wasn't doing numbers. Whole life was going under.
Damn.
I'm schooled and my dad and I had face facing in Atlanta. He said it's 1 million chance and I told him, daddy, I ain't never wanna.
I know what he said at the end there. I am that water. Don't know what that means. But he's basically talking about how he was down bad. In the summer, he was sleeping at his sister's house. His mama didn't believe in him. His daddy didn't believe in him. But now look, it all worked out in the end. Ooh, if I didn't make it, I would have died trying to be here. Something about suicide trying to be here. He wanted it bad. But the thing is, it's not just like everybody wants something, but you have to have like the talent to get it, you know what I mean? You have to have some substance. There are people who even make it into the industry. I'm not going to name names because I'm not in a messy mood. But there are people who are... Coi Leray. People are in the industry. Sure, they have some bops, but it's like, are you really that talented? You know what I'm trying to say? He has it. He has the entire package. He has a drive. He has the talents. He has the vision. So, of course, he ended up where he was supposed to be, because that's what his destiny... Those are all the traits that God gave him. Or whoever you believe in. That's who Odin, Hercules, that's who gave him everything he needed to be equipped to get to where he wants. And it was up to him to just keep working towards it. Like he just said, he left college. He was bumming at his sister's house. He was struggling to get to where he wants. I like that part. Everybody come up to you, hallelujah, how you doing? A vibe, just a vibe. But I kind of relate to that because I'm not famous. I don't think I'm famous, and I don't think I'm on Lil Nas's level. But when I say that people that I barely even talked to in high school, or people that I didn't even talk to in high school, all of a sudden DMing me, hey, Faye, or Faye, calling me Fave. My best friends don't even call me Fave. So what are you doing in my DMs, you crusty bastard, calling me Fave? Like, you know me like that. Back up. I know you're just here because, oh, she got 100K subscribers. But at the end of the day, this is more like just like a community. You know what I'm trying to say. This isn't like me. To me, this is just like me and 100K friends vibing to music. You know what I mean? This is like a personal community. And people, I guess, who don't really understand it, see it as like something bigger, I guess. I don't know. I'm going on a tangent. Dead right now. Hold on. This is giving me, I remember, I want you, it is safe to... Doja Cat. And Doja Cat's on the album. Perfect.
Tell me she be clean, but I'm knowing that I have to deceive her. My mama told me that she love me, don't believe her.
Oi!
She get drunk, she hit me up, man, with a fever like, whoa.
Mommy issues. Relatable. Shout out to the MILFs.
She ain't even out that pretty. She ain't even out that nigga.
Yeah.
She ain't even out when the God will forgive it. Shit. She ain't even out that pretty. She ain't even out that nigga. She ain't even out when the God will forgive it. You know I never did you wrong.
This is a vibe.
You know I'm right about the phone, girl. You know you never used to come. Keep it that way
now.
Treat you like
it. Oh, right now. I'm on your hair right now.
You want to fuck with me so
there right now. Like that part, how the beat cut. Like a zombie having an orgasm. Okay, I would rate that probably an 8.5 out of 10 or a 9 out of 10. That was really good. And also, can I just mention the fact that this album came out maybe almost a month ago, and I forced myself not to listen to it because I knew you hoes would want a reaction. And here I am giving it to you. Anyways, late is better than never, right? We've already heard Industry Baby, we've already reacted to it, go watch my reaction. Now we got That's What I Want. I don't know what it'll sound like. Let's get it, though. Someone to love me. We saw this preview. Hold on, I gotta shut my door. Don't want the neighbors filing a noise complaint. There's a black girl making noise. Come shoot her. I'm just joking. That's a bad joke. Not me coming back after a month and getting canceled again. I've been canceled enough times. This is the Matrix. You didn't see me or hear me say what I just said. Anyways, here we go. I can't even drink my soda. Talking about the members of the rainbow acronym. He said, do you got the G or the B? Either way, can you play with me? Lil Nas X, he wants a booty. Hey, hey! Someone to love me! Yeah, this is the weird, like, intergalactic phone booth preview. I remember this song. I was excited to hear it because the vibes are just really good. But it's his gay sexual anthem, apparently. He said, do you got the G or you got the B? That's obviously the rainbow acronym. LGBT. G. B. You know? So he's asking the dude. It's really cool that he can be very open about it. It's nice. Because, you know, the people who can relate to it, relate to it. And it's like, up to this point, they really haven't had something that robust and that out there, that direct, saying it. So it's nice that they can now have that in Lil Nas X. Like, he's a great representation. It's always good to have representation. Always good. Someone to need me. The vocal range on this man, who would have thought? Come on, rock star Avril Lavigne. What's her name? Olivia Rodrigo? And now this new, happier than ever Billie Eilish, but making a black man. Lil Nas X.
Look, you know it's hard to define these times, but I got nothing but love on my mind. I need a baby with a line in my prime. Need an adversary to my down and rare. Like, tell me that's life when I'm stressing at night. Be like, you'll be okay and everything's alright.
Ho, 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 ho. His tone on this song is completely different than anything I've ever heard. Even the one, what's the song with freaking Cardi B? Rodeo, that's the, but even Rodeo was kind of like Old Town Road-ish vibes. I don't know, there's just something about this song that is very different. Like, it's giving me very much punk, it's giving me very much electric guitar, it's giving me very much combat boots and like skinny jeans, you know what I mean? He's doing a lot, and I love it all. Like, tell me that's life when I'm stressing at night. Be like, you'll be okay and everything's alright. Let me in nothing cause I'm not wanting anything. But you're loving your body and a little bit of your brain. This day's going too long. I'm missing out, I know. This day's going too long. And I'm not forgiving, love away, but I want was a bop, for sure. Absolutely stupendous, phenomenal, amazing. It's just, it's Lil Nas X. What do you expect? Next up we have The Art of Realization. I assume this is him coming out of the closet. The closet? The wardrobe? Coming out of it. It's 24 seconds long, so let's see.
I've been driving a lot. Just driving. In life. With no actual direction. I'm heading towards units.
Oh, I thought he was giving us a day in the life, but he's talking about a metaphor. Let's go back.
In life, with no actual direction, I'm not heading towards any specific place. That's like for who? Is it for me? Am I happy?
What the?
Not sure.
Hold on. So The Art of Realization, the entire introduction to that thing is like, he's talking, I guess, through his emotions and thoughts and like trying to figure himself out. And then towards like the middle-ish end of it, it gets all chaotic and it was kind of hurting my ears because it was like a bunch of noise going on. And in the background, you could still hear him like trying to figure it out. And at the very end, the sound cuts and he's like, I'm sure. I'm not sure if I'm happy to silence, I'm sure. So homie he's blossomed, he's happy now. The Art of Realization. Really? Oh, bitch, we're 5 songs in. We got 10 more. I'm already exhausted from the greatness. Next up, Scoop featuring Doja Cat. What is this gonna sound like? I don't know. Scoop de poop or some weird sounds. Here we go.
I've been working on my body. You ever seen a nigga in Pilates?
Pilates?
No, I ain't feeling sorry. Been in the kitchen pumping Nazarati. Shit, I've been in the crib going crazy. I've been moving work on the daily. Baby, ain't trying to be a baby. Understand, I'm just trying to be the daily. Scoop.
Hey!
Scoop,
scoop, scoop, scoop. A bop. It's a bop.
Been moving work on the daily. Baby ain't trying to be a baby. Understand, I'm just trying to be the daily.
Barking at me. An electric guitar too in the background.
You ain't with that. No, it's that you get flown in the sit back. And I won't call on the phone if I hit that. And I'm trying to fuck little nigga fuck the chit chat. Ain't fucking guns when I ask where you dick at.
Again? gang banging, but it's just a gang bang. Oh my god. Oh my god!
Where your dick at? Not the gun.
Oh my god! Wow. I'm sorry, are we really just about to move on? Like, that wasn't, like, kind of ingenious, but at the same time, what the fuck? Just straight out there, that's wild. Okay, whatever, we're moving on. Where your dick at? Okay. Ooh.
It's the queen herself. It's the queen herself. I'm not ready. Let's go back a little bit. Here we go.
Come on, Doja. Hold on. I just got my veneers off. Bitches wanna rip my face off or something. Huh, hold on. I'ma get the bar. Calm down, hold on. And now my body look like something you did take off. I just got my veneers out, bitches wanna rip their face off, but you thought you'd have a chance at Okay, I just got my veneers out, bitches wanna rip their face off. Is she saying cause she got her veneers out and she's still a bad bee. She doesn't even need the fake teeth. And girls are jealous cause of that. Y'all are just weird. Why are you jealous of somebody's teeth? Bitches is birds. Wanna disrespect me? Let him apologize, I need it in a belly. Apologize, I need it in a belly. What was that voice, Doja? Face off, but you thought you'd have a chance after you wanna disrespect me? Let him apologize, I need it in a belly. Cheating my right cheek, turn up right and left one low. Y'all are coming for us big forehead peoples. I got a 5, but I'm still cute. 4? It's a 5. Ouch. Scoop! Okay, we got it. You and your Pilates. Next, we got One of Me featuring... I'm sorry. I know we went through the features, but it literally just, like, it just clicked on my brain. I don't know if y'all have seen those videos where it's, like, a compilation of... I don't know. The one I just saw recently was, like, the top songs of every month from the 1960s. And from, like, 1960 to 1962-ish... The songs were good, obviously, but they were very, in comparison to this huge change that is going to happen, which is the Beatles coming out, it was like a steady, it was a good steady, but it was a steady staleness. And then all of a sudden in like 1962, 1963, you get this weird, I wanna hold your hand, the Beatles, coming out with like this thing that no one has ever heard before. Mid-early 1960s, and they completely changed the course of music in, like, a few matter of years. They completely turned it upside down. They created a whole new genre, essentially. So you're telling me a man who did that is now on a song with Lil Nas X? that just attests to me how phenomenal Lil Nas X is. If you can get Elton John to co-sign one of your songs to be on a song with you, you're doing something right. You're on the right track to somewhere. If a goat like that believes in you, you're doing something right. I don't know what the song is going to sound like. I don't know. I'd assume Elton's going to have a verse. How the heck is he going to sound with Lil Nas X? I don't know. But again, this is just like, this song existing at all is iconic status. No one can say anything to Lil Nas X at this point, like, in my opinion. What are you going to say? Oh, you're gay? He is proudly, you dummy. You have shit music? Okay, but he's charting. Where are you? In your mother's basement. Typing, talking shit in a comments section. Like a bum. Anyways, here we go into One of Me. Okay, it's a sad song. Whoa. It's like, I feel sad, but also I'm vibing. It's like contradictory. Huh.
Say you wanna be, say you need the validation. Tell me that you think you on top of last creation.
What word on the block is you feel like I'm just saying there ain't no town.
Okay, so this song is from the perspective, like we were just talking about, haters. From the perspective of a hater. Interesting. Elton John co-signed this song? Okay, let's keep listening. But yeah, I like you, then you do that. Don't do this, don't do that. Say you're one of me, say you're one of me. Okay, so it's from the perspective of a hater. And I think maybe also the LGBTQ community. Both trying to control him as a person or as an artist is what I'm getting so far.
Do what you best, I suggest. Make another one like this.
Huh.
I know it was only luck. If you drop a song, nigga, we won't give a fuck, no.
How you make a hit talking shit about yourself? What dimension is this man living in? I know he's always doing these intergalactic themes, and it's because he's not from this earth. Like, he doesn't think on the same wavelength as the rest of us. Because how do you turn shit-talking into a bop? How do you turn shit-talking into bars? You know what I'm trying to say? Like, how do you make that entire encapsulation of hate into a bop? Like, where do they connect? How do you do that? It's just something that's not in my database. Where's Elton's verse? Okay, we're over halfway through the song, so I'm wondering where's Elton?
Is a joke, been a gimmick from the go. All the things that you do just to get your face to show. Oh, you think you big shit, big pimpin', let me know. Ain't the next big thing, you the next thing to go. Now, can you prove yourself, everybody wait on?
Hold on. Excuse me, my screen turned off.
I'm just being real, swear somebody hit on. I don't see you lasting long, and it's just me being honest. Even if your album okay is flopping, that's a promise, so
shut the fuck up, you dummy. What do you mean? Ugh, people are just so annoying. I just feel, ugh. If all you have to do, I even know there's gonna be people like this watching this video right now. If your only purpose of being on the internet, or if you get gratification by being mean or talking-ish about other people or just putting other people down, you are a loser. You're a loser. You're, like, that's just loser mentality, loser actions. If you have enough time and energy to give towards negativity, but also trying to bring someone else down who's doing good, that just speaks about you. I'm sorry to say, you're a loser. Like, genuinely, that's loser behavior. Like, you should not have enough energy or time to be doing that. That just means that you have nothing else going for you, or you're not working towards anything. Like, what's your credit score? How's your family living? If you're up on the internet commenting all day talking shit. Says a lot about you.
I like this, I don't like that. Do this, don't you do that.
Say you wanna me, say you wanna me, yeah, yeah. Outro's nice. Don't tell me that the Elton John... Oh, the Elton John feature is piano keys. We didn't get a verse. I wanna hold your hand. Come on, Elton. We got piano keys. I wanted to hear him pop off, but... Next up, we got Lost in the Citadel. When I think of Citadel, I think of Game of Thrones when Cersei Lannister blew up the entire crypt and all the little bastards in there. By the way, I know Cersei has a bad rep, but I love her regardless. Anyways, we got lost in the Citadel. His struggle with faith, maybe? Or religion?
Tell me, are you feeling down?
I thought my speakers were messing up for a second.
Are you happy? Do your dreams still seem in them? Tell me, are we finished now? Cause every time you leave, you find a way to come back around.
Excuse me. Avril Lavigne, Olivia Rodrigo, but make it a black man. Again. This is, I think, the second rockish song that we've gotten on the album so far. He's like multi-genre, multi-dimensional. Obviously, for me anyway, when I think of Lil Nas X, I do think of rap. But this is like showcasing that he can do everything. He can incorporate everything. Like, sure, he's rapping, but it's a rock song. It's a pop punk song, pop rock, whatever. He can do everything. Okay, MGK. Is actually, like, I didn't know he could sing. I don't think we've gotten to hear him sing this far. Industry Baby, he was rapping. Montero, he's rapping. What's that one? Gum, get it from me for free. Because if that song, whatever it was called, he was singing a little bit, but not to this caliber.
I thought you were somewhere like you've been to, so I hit you now what you're getting into.
Vibe. I would give this, I haven't been ranking them, my bad. I would give this one though 8 out of 10 too. This song is a vibe. Did you hear the background vocals? This song, though, for real. What's your favorite song from the album? Comment down below your top three. I feel like this is going to be in my top three, for sure. John, it's the Elton John effect, because all these instrumentals, the outros have been really, like, I could just listen to that alone, you know? But anyways, next up we got Dollar Sign Slam featuring Megan Thee Stallion. Late on my stomach, tooted up, do a cry baby, now he annihilated. Okay, we're getting hood now, hood. Hold on, he's talking to shit. I'm running it back.
Y'all take a room and y'all going weird up. Fucker that talk about who's in the whereabouts.
Ooh.
I walk in Nemus and Marcus and bear it up.
Ooh.
Walking the bangers and fuck, let's clear it up.
Let's clear out!
I'm the same dollar sign.
He's talking his shit to all you hating bastards. You deserve it.
You just the up in the flap of a nigga. I'm sorry that I gotta say the truth. Thought I would pop out of all of you niggas.
Oh, thought I would pop out of pop. Ooh, I like that. Alliteration. Come through, literary devices.
Sorry that I gotta say the truth. Thought I would pop out of all of you niggas. Now I'm with the hills like on Favour.
Woo! 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 He's going off. Y'all have angered him. You've angered the Mac Daddy bottom. Is he a bottom? I don't know. I think he said it at some point.
Shoot is the up in the flap of a nigga. I'm sorry that I gotta say the truth. I thought I would pop out of all of you niggas. Now I'm with the hills like I'm Babe Ruth. Bitch, you're not too late, bro. Talk about who's in the whereabouts.
Oh my god. I go to Neiman's
and Marcus and
Bear it out.
Walking to Bengals and fuck, let's clear it out.
Let's be honest, so that's not a good financial choice, but then again, he can make it all back because he's that talented.
I'm the same dollar sign. I'm the same dollar sign.
Hold on, horse lady. I'm not ready. Oh, God. Also, just came to mind, I was on Twitter and it was trending. Her and what was Megan Thee Stallion doing in Korea? What was she doing with BTS? And they were out here doing some sign language stuff for TikTok and What was that about? Did they have a... That's how out of the loop I've been. If they have a song together that has dropped, I didn't even know about it. Someone let me know. And should we react? Comment down below.
I'm the same dollar sign. I'm the same dollar sign.
Real hype shit. They can't stop me. Say I can't do it, bitch. Watch me. On these lame hoes turn hate to a hobby. Damn, watching me gotta turn you on. I should have my own category and point. Ooh, I'm just...
Say what now?
To a hobby. Damn, watching me gotta turn you on. I should have my own category and point. Ooh,
imagine. Wake up in the morning. Let me get a quick scratch out. Let's go on to the hub. Megan Thee Stallion. Let's click that one. And it's just her music videos. I'm sure someone would be into it. Not me, though.
Such an obsession. See about me. IG suggestions. No add-on prosthetics. Everything.
everything about me came from genetics.
Oh! She called y'all some plastic bimbo hoes. Her ass is real, yours isn't.
Specialty about me, IG suggestions. No add-on prosthetics. Everything about me came from genetics. I've been getting money, I ain't new to this. Miss wanna catch one, I ain't new to fish. But if he throwing that rod, can I get hooked for you doing your job?
Not a fishing analogy. If he throws that rod and I get hooked, she's talking about a... My audience are... If you know, you know. She said if I get hooked onto it, though, you're doing your job. Oh my. Why does it gotta be so dang vivid? Why can I actually see it in my mind? Man. Ah! We're moving on. In fact, we're moving on to the next song. These analogies. It's ingenious how they're able to use so many different metaphors to describe the same thing. Anyways, we got Tales of Dominican Republic. Gives me very much Roddy Ricch. What song was that? If you know what I'm talking about, comment down below. Roddy Ricch.
Woke up on the floor, old as plastic bed, don't blow up no more.
Woke up on the floor, this plastic bed doesn't blow up anymore. He's talking about a blow up mattress, sleeping on the floor. Oh god. We're taking it back to the bum days. Okay, Lil Nas, here we go.
In this broken home, everyone becomes predictable.
Oh no. Did he have a messed up family life? He said, that was a hiccup. He said in his family, no. In this broken home, everyone becomes predictable. I'm sorry. Everybody's just traumatized at this point. It's like a normal, if you have no family trauma from growing up, consider yourself lucky, bitch.
Oh, sometimes we're angry, sometimes we're hurting, sometimes we're alone.
This is gonna be one of those that speaks to your soul. Like, if you understand me, we understand him, we understand.
Oh, sometimes we're angry, sometimes we're hurting, sometimes we're alone.
This is another good one. Whoa. I think he was just saying, I'm just too busy vibing. I wasn't listening to what he was saying. He said he's been bumming around and his life is falling apart. Life sucks. But he can't go back home because he can't face, I guess, Demonica, who I'm going to say is his mother. He can't go back home and face her and be like, he dropped out of college trying to chase his dream. And if he goes home and admits that he's failed, it's going to be like, he just doesn't want to do that. So it's like, suffer until you succeed kind of thing. Whoa. What an imagery. He paid attention in English class. And I'm not even trying to be funny. Like, actually, the metaphors in this album and the lyrics, whether they be sexual or not sometimes, shout out to freaking Megan Thee Stallion, they're very vivid. He said, I've been floating in an oceanless sea or something like that. Hold on, I'm going back. Oceanless sea. Okay, I was imagining like you're floating in the ocean, but there's no water in it. But he said an oceanless sea. I'm floating in an oceanless sea. Bitch, I don't understand, actually. What was I talking about? I don't know.
Could I be wrong? Was everybody right about me? Scary things in my head. I can't dream and I just woke up on the floor.
literally just taking it. This is kind of what Billie did with her album, Happier Than Ever. Like, just a peek into their subconscious of what they've been struggling with. Like, he's been going back and forth. Is he as bad as people are trying to make him seem? Was this all worth it? Is he going to accomplish what he wants to accomplish? Is he a good person? Again, was any of this worth it? Internal conflicts, and those are, like, really scary things. And he said it's all going on in his mind. Wow. How do you turn that into a song? Huh. Like, it's just gonna trail out like that, but I would just like to make it a fact, speak it properly, and say it to your face. Tales of Dominica, best song from the album. With the least amount of streams, you guys get the streams up, but that's the, like, most heartfelt bop I've listened to so far. Next, we got Sun Goes Down. Let's see. Saying though about, like, he touches so many different genres, because this is kind of like a somber lullaby but make it pop-ish. He's unpredictable.
You
You've already listened to this. We've reacted to this. This is where he's in his bedroom and, like, looking back on all the different characters he's been in, music videos, his life, all that. We've heard this before. So we're gonna move on to Void. Emotions. He said, lately I've been feeling as small as a salt in the sea. And bitch, that's like microscopic. So he's been feeling really bad. Oh, man. Now I feel like I have to deal with it. What am I supposed to do? Oh, no. Huh.
So much to do, it's all the dub of time. I feel like I feel a little behind.
Oh! No! Too many songs on this album, like, I can relate to. Too freaking many. I'm sick of it. Ugh, man. I'm not gonna cry. I'm not gonna cry. I refuse.
Hold on, hold on. It seems hard to reach the place I wanna be. Whoever thought I'd get there anyway. Hold on.
Wait, it's positive.
Way too late.
God didn't like him, why'd he make him so talented? Answer me that. Come on! About to build into like this huge beat drop, and it's like, I'm not gonna say that comparison favor again, family friendly, get your mind out of the gutter, but it's like building up, you know, and then it doesn't happen, if you know what I'm trying to say.
Find a love who loves me the same or as much as you do. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Oh, I reach out my hand hoping that they'll see I'm more than one.
This is actually kind of a song, a sad song though, because he's talking about all the pressure that being him has brought onto himself, basically.
I reach out my hand, hoping that they'll see I'm more than one, and everyone tells me, hold on, hold on, hold on. See, I'm tired of the way I'm living. I'd rather die than live with this feeling stuck in this world.
Damn, he's so real. He said, every win gives me more room to lose. Like, as he keeps elevating in his career, that's just, like, more room for him to fall. That's insane. When you really think about it, like, sure, you're winning, you're up, but that you can fall even, just as much as you elevate, you can fall right back down. That's a scary thought. And every day he's pushing the barriers, too.
Whatever.
Prostitution. Gosh dang it. That was a vibe. That was a sad vibe, though. Void. That's a lot. That one was extreme. Next up, we got an explicit song. Don't Want It. Okay, let's see. Hold, 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 hold. You can't make me emotional, feeling all bad for you now, and you want me to shake my ass in the next song. Freaking Jesus. Bipolarism. Ugh.
If I say so, no, they gon' ride. I know GZ, no, they ain't not. If I pop up, I'm a wanted, but I get by. Tell the devil I can't have a missile. Tell the reaper he don't want it, he don't want it. Oh, everything's gonna be alright.
Whoa, whoa, okay. I thought, oh. At first I was, oh. I thought he said devil can come inside, and I was about to say, excuse me, we got to move on to the next song. But then he said, Reaper, you can't have it, or something like that. So, I think he's casting out the devil. So, Christians, calm down.
But I get by. Tell the devil I can't have a missile. Tell the Reaper he don't want it. He don't want it. Oh, everything's gonna be alright. Tell the
lot about the death, a lot about offing yourself. So at some point, was homie, you know, I'm trying to be choosy with my words because YouTube platform, but at some point, was he struggling is my question. I hope not, because he's a gem.
Wonder everything's gonna be alright. I smoke myself to sleep. I'm sad. I think I'm feeling lonely.
I think that answers my question. Okay.
Took one too many shots last night and I spent all my money.
Started thinking, am I stupid? Could be funny. Over things that been haunting me all my life. Ain't no fucking living proof that if you want it, you can have anything right before your eyes.
Yeah. Like 3 months, Old Town Road. I hated the song after a while, but it, like, that's legendary. Didn't it beat out I Wanna Hold Your Hand? The Beatles? He was reigning longer than the Beatles on the charts. Now that says something. And then after that, you have a song with one of the Beatles. Like, people don't comprehend. Sure, he's gay. You want to be mad about that? You're dumb. Sure, you don't like his music. You just lack taste. But you cannot deny the fact that homie is an up-and-coming legend. And that's just it. If you are angry about that, you're just stupid. Man.
Call Me By Your Name by Lil Nas X.
I want it fame and
that was recent.
Wanted happiness, wanted forgiveness. Started focusing on all these wishes. Crazy how this shit come to fruition.
Yeah.
Things in my past. I'm sorry for so pleased to hold me.
This song is, like, a lot. He just said to the old people in my life, just know that I'm not the old me. So he's even reaching out and, like, kind of apologizing to his past life, his past people, his past self, for his past self. But also he's, like, talking about how he's come up and he's successful now and it's all because he's worked towards it and it's come to fruition. This entire song is really just, like, growth. That's the best way I can describe the song. Don't want it? I really like it. And in the beginning, I thought it was just going to be another devil-worshipping controversy. But no, this song is really good. I don't know. I need, like, I think I just can't hear. He said Moana? Make way, Moana, it's time you knew. The island of Matu Nu. Did he say Moana? I like that song. Because he believed in himself. He came up. And now he's still reaching out. He's still the same old Lil Nas X, same old Lil Montero. Life after Salem, Martin Luther King Jr. Got another, like, Western? If he were a drag queen. 007, but instead of using guns, they're using butt plugs or something. That's what I'm getting.
Man, who's to blame if you don't love me no more? No, I don't mind, just take whatever you want.
It's like mysterious.
Why don't you just take what you want? You should take what you want and leave. Why don't you just take what you want from me?
this. Ooh, hold on. We're about to get a huge. He's about to yell, I can tell. But I'm gonna say this song is kind of depressing.
I think you should take what you want.
He's about to yell. I can hear it.
What you want from me? Yeah.
Oh my god.
What you want from me? Yeah.
I feel played by everybody. Everyone's fake. Lil Nas X a rapper? No. Homie's a rock star. Billie Eilish is depressed? Still, yeah, I guess. Happier than ever, but still depressing as hell. But bitch, did you hear? But I don't talk shit about you on the internet. It's not anyone, anything bad. It's like everybody's evolving, and I'm trying to keep up. Gotham City. Adderall.
Then throw me up against the wall.
Toxic. Come on, Nas. You deserve so much better. Whatever, if this is a reference to an old relationship he had, I hope he's out of it, because homie deserves better. Everybody deserves better than what the song's talking about.
Us guys still dance with each other. I can be your part-time lover. Us guys still dance with each other.
Our scars, they'll dance with each other? No, actually, because this is the second time on this album. If you remember back to Montero, call me whenever you want, call me whenever you need, call me, I'm on the way, life after Salem now, take what you want from me. Like, homie is better than just being a side piece. I hope he knows that. Everybody's better than just being the side chick. Unless you're happy being the side chick, then you're a buster.
I think you should take what you want and leave. Why don't you just take what you want from me? I think you should take what you want and leave. What you want from me?
Jeez. Didn't expect this at all. Guitar solo. That was a 10 second guitar solo. Erotic. This song is very nice. Not the Western whistle. Homie's just being used and abused. Come on, though. Ugh. Anyways, last up we got Am I Dreaming? At this point, where's Noah?
Oh.
Excuse me. I've been drinking a soda. Calm down. Anyways, where's Noah Cyrus? We've got Billy Bob. We got Miley. Now we just need Noah to complete the Holy Trinity. Where's she at? Come on. Am I dreaming? Let's see. A lot of guitar on this album, I've noticed.
Every song, every dream filled with hell from beyond. As I'm thinking, I relive the story.
Every dream filled with hell from beyond. As I'm dreaming, I'm reliving the story. Gorgeous. Shakespearean. Ugh. The Globe was inspired by Lil Nas X himself. Dramatic Favour.
As I'm thinking, I relive the story. Every try, every breakthrough, and every cry.
Dude has taken a chapter out of Kanye West's book with these layerings of vocals, the singing, the like electronicness of it. It's working. I really like it.
Every try, every breakthrough, and every cry. As I'm sinking, I relive the story.
X and Osiris. I need Lil Nas X and Youngblood, the guy from the UK with the big lips. All of it. Oh! I'm faded! What? Freaking Miley was on the song. She has such a peculiar voice as well. It's just, I don't know if I've ever said it on the channel actually, but my top three songs ever, like in the existence of this channel existing, in the existence of me being alive, my top three albums: SZA, Control, Rihanna, Anti, Miley Cyrus, Bangers. Those three albums, the Rihanna, Anti, and Bangers Miley, shaped who I was through middle school and high school. And then when I graduated and became a college student, I could relate to Control. Because it was like young adult, coming into who you are, you know, whatever, growth. Different steps in my life, those three albums. So I say that to say, Miley Cyrus is like, in my eyes, she can do no wrong. Now, I have to admit, I've just been very caught up in, like, life, and I haven't been able to go along with her in this rock series that she's doing, or rock era that she has. I haven't heard Pink Hearts or Purple Hearts, whatever it's called, or any of her other rock stuff. But that being said, still, from Banger's era, I'll always be a Miley Cyrus stan. Let's go back. I'm not even ready for her verse on this dang song. I already know it's going to be amazing. My God.
And everything I've done,
tears running dry, shattered inside, but I still got a smile.
Wait, what the fuck? Come on! Who do you know who can sing like that? Stevie Nicks? But who else? No one. You're lying. Favour, actually,
Melanie Martinez, Adele,
shut up! No! No! Miley's one of one, and that's why I love her so much.
As I'm sinking, I relive the story. Glitter comes on.
Like, looks into her voice! Is very much Joan Jett, but make it Miley Cyrus.
Smile as I'm sinking.
When the glitter comes off. So underneath all this celebrity crap, underneath the money, underneath the diamonds, the lifestyle, all that, I'm messed up. I'm busted. I'm tragic just like the rest of you. But we gotta keep going, is basically what the song is about. Excuse me, that harmony. Who would have thought? Billy Ray, gave us an inkling. But this is the best feature from the album. Elton John, sure, he's Elton John, he's an icon. But homie was just some piano keys. This is Miley Cyrus harmonizing with Lil Nas X. Amazing. Noah, bring that ass here. Out of me? What was that? You didn't have to. I don't know. You didn't have to kill us like that. What is this accent? I don't know. But I feel it, you know? Miley! Extra. She just did it because she can. The faded! Ooh. Oh! Shut up. God, I'm sick of them. Hey, that was, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. I don't even, like, at what, whoa.